for us, and God wants us to be righteous people. May we live out a righteous existence, radiating our love for God in all we do and speak. Let us use the great gift of the Eucharist as a driving force in our lives to propel us to the kingdom of heaven, to remind us of God's love for us, and a spiritual nourishment fueling our deep love of the Lord. Our second collection today is to support our St. Vincent de Paul ministry. Thank you for generously supporting the vulnerable and those in need in our community. Please stand.
Please join us in our opening song, Our God is Here, number 304.
For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation and nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those who foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul them ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous, throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things? They answered, yes. And he replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings forth from his storeroom both the new and the old. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Been about almost a year and a half, I think, since I was here. Before that, I was here for 6 years. For those who don't remember, for those who don't recognize me, I guess you came in the most recent year and a half, or you weren't paying attention. I have to say, when I was pastor in Richmond, I was there for 12 years, and the last year I was there, I still had people coming asking me if I was the new priest. Obviously, they don't go to Mass often enough, I guess. Anyway, it's been okay being retired. The members of the house come and go. We had, since December, we had two of them die, and then we got another fellow. So there's three of us in the house right now, but they're in the process of doing some painting and stuff in the other empty room, so maybe that means we're going to get some new faces sometimes. You never know. On the other hand, we did have a break-in last month, so in my room. Nothing bad happened in the end, other than getting in. So I think we should be thankful. It's not the best neighborhood, but it's okay. I will talk about a little bit about sometimes neighbors can be annoying. Yes, I have a neighbor on one side that is, well, all the neighborhood is Hispanic, and the neighbors on both sides like mariachi music, and they like to have fiestas, And sometimes it seems like every Friday and Saturday night there's extremely loud mariachi music next door. Luckily, I like mariachi music, but I don't like it that much. But you know, Jesus never said it was going to be easy to love your neighbor. He gives easy to understand commandments, but they're not always easy to put into practice. Tonight we have a series of parables from Jesus. They're short, but they are to the point, especially the one about the treasure in the field and the pearl of great price. And in both cases, the person sells everything they have in order to gain that pearl or that treasure. It's kind of saying, what is the kingdom of God worth? What is the kingdom of God worth? Jesus says, it's worth everything we have. But I have to say and ask the question, do we act like it? How much do we value the kingdom of God? Do we value it enough to make sacrifices for it? Enough to give up everything else? I have to say, when I'm honest with myself, not always. On good days, yeah. Bad days, not so much. One of the reasons why the martyrs are such important examples for us and why the earliest canonized saints were all martyrs is because they're people who really did give up everything for the kingdom of God. Literally, their own lives. And that is demonstrates, you know, how important it is, our relationship with God. St. Polycarp, we know mainly because he wrote a bunch of letters on his way to Rome to be executed. He was saying in some of those letters, don't try and rescue me. If you try and rescue me, you're going to deprive me of the chance to be a martyr for God, a witness for God, to give everything for the Lord. It's not necessarily an attitude I find attractive, but the thing was, he was trying to put his money where his mouth is, but he also knew human nature is weak. And sometimes when you're facing the lions, it's easy to maybe take another way out. Fortunately for us, most of us are not literally facing lions. Most of us are not likely to face martyrdom. Probably that's just as well. But we are called to make sacrifices for the sake of the kingdom of God. But as I say, it's difficult. I don't often love God with all my heart, all my soul, all my mind, and all my strength. Not as if my life depended on it. And sometimes I don't love my neighbor as myself. Especially when the mariachi music goes till 10 or 11 o'clock at night. But you know, not all of us are called to do this in enormous, spectacular ways. So I want to call to mind St. Teresa of Lisieux, you know, very famous for her little way to Jesus. She actually wanted to become a missionary, and preferably to some place like the Pacific Islands or someplace where there were cannibals or something, so she could become a martyr. Luckily for us, I guess, she didn't, because she was able to write her diary, which is quite a great book. She wasn't able to give big sacrifices because her health was very bad. She died in her 20s of tuberculosis, and the convent where they lived did not have any central heating and didn't have any air conditioning. It was just this big old drafty stone building, not conducive to respiratory health, you might say. So she wasn't able to do big things. So she said, well, if I can't do big things, I'll do small things with great love. One of Mother Teresa's big statements. In fact, she chose the name Teresa because of Teresa was you and her way. Doing the small things in front of you, but with great love. And that could be as simple as making a sandwich or making a small sacrifice. Teresa was you, one of her sacrifices was she had to take care of one of the older sisters who was like in a wheelchair and very cantankerous. Never had a kind word, it's just complaining all the time. And no one has ever met anybody like that. But she was very difficult, but in fact, when her term came up, Teresa volunteered to continue doing that. And in fact, after Teresa's own death, this was one of the nuns that was first in line to vote for her canonization. It had an effect. Why did Teresa do this? Because those little sacrifices with great love are sacrifices you make for the kingdom, especially if they're for people you don't like, but even if they aren't. You do it because if you're open to looking for the little things or the things in front of you that you can do, you're open to God. And God will show you opportunities if you're open to them. Life is full of little things you can do to improve somebody else's life, to put up with an annoying person. Some days I have to say, it's just try to be less grumpy. Let someone go ahead of you in line at the grocery store. Look up a smile at somebody in the grocery store. Overtip somebody. And a lot of people are in circumstances where that might be the only act of kindness they're going to get that day. And if you do it out of love for God, it makes a big difference. People need to be reminded that there is goodness, there is kindness, and there's love in the world. All you need to have proof of that is to look at the newspaper or watch the news in the evening. There's a lot of other things going on. And it seems like there's nothing you can do. But you can make a difference for one person in front of you, even if it's a little difference, and show them that maybe there is some goodness, some love, and some kindness in the world. That can give hope. From hope comes change. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With one voice, let us offer our prayers to God, trusting him to provide for our needs.
For church leaders, that they may continue to listen closely to the voice of the Holy Spirit as they guide and lead the faithful, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
those in positions of authority, that they may have understanding hearts, motivated by compassion and the desire to serve the common good, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the young people of the world, that they may be inspired to live and witness the gospel in their own lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our families, that they may grow in grace and live with deeper dedication to the treasure of our Catholic faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those recovering from surgery or prolonged illness, that they may know the compassion of Christ through the support of their caregivers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, especially Rico Branson and Marta Torres, that they may be immersed in eternal joy in the heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This evening's Mass is offered for Barbara Ford. For her, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and loving God, hear our prayers, which we humbly offer to you, and we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory song, Drawn to You, number 398.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all this holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in paschal mystery. So with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile to us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brief advertisement here. Do you long to be closer to the Lord? Have you ever wondered what it would be like to be among his apostles 2,000 years ago, being guided and learning directly from Jesus, being his friend? You cannot come closer to Christ in this life than you get with the Eucharist. Through the Eucharist, you can have the same intimacy, experience the learning, growth, and friendship, and be immersed in the love of Jesus as his apostles experienced in Christ's ministry on earth. We hold ourselves back from this experience by lack of understanding or lack of faith. Learn how to move closer to Jesus, be in his inner circle. The diocese is hosting a Eucharistic Revival Congress where you will learn and grow in faith and proximity to Christ. St. Mary would like to have a large delegation representing our parish on September 15th and 16th, September 8th and 9th in Spanish. Let's gather to pray, to adore, to hear dynamic speakers, and to learn to grow as close to Christ as possible. A small registration fee is corrected to cover the cost of food and drink, which will be provided. Information is available at the parish office. After Sunday Mass, there's a table outside the front door, or visit the diocese website, hopediocese.org.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go now in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Please join our closing song, Go Make a Difference.